This year, a group of teenage students, led by their geography teacher, took on sailing's biggest offshore event, the Rolex Fastnet Race. Until 3 years ago, none had any idea about sailing, let alone racing 600 miles offshore from Cowes to Plymouth via the southwestern tip of Ireland. And why should they? The Greg City Academy is an inner London school in a deprived area. Landlocked at the heart of a crowded city, there couldn't be fewer links with the sea, and even fewer to sailing. But there was one.
Project Scaramouche started in 2013, and it was my vision to try and get sailing accessible to students from the inner city school where I work. I've sailed all my life, and I've seen the benefits that sailing can give of resilience and what you can achieve through hard work, cope with different conditions. So I hope to instill that sense of resilience in the boys that do the project.
A project that was about more than ticking off a life experience. The Fastnet campaign was about taking another step into a new world, and they knew it.
I probably would have been a bit confused because I don't think I would do anything in the sailing world because we're in an inner city area, and yeah, you wouldn't think of doing such a big challenge like that.
At first, I was just a bit overwhelmed because we've been building up for this for 2 years now.
Their journey had started with small boats in Poole Harbour. From there, they progressed to an Etchells 22, before moving on to their 43-footer Scaramouche. Even then, learning to sail was just part of the process. Getting Scaramouche to the start line meant attracting support for their campaign.
For Project Scaramouche to run, it's a bit like a small business, so they've learned how to speak to trust funds, how to deal with inner city firms who might sponsor the project, and at the same time they've had to develop their sailing skills as well. So the whole project is self-funded by the work that they've done, speaking to suppliers, international yachtsmen like Laurie Smith and all these sorts of very supportive people.
By the time the Fastnet start came, they had a refitted boat and plenty of sea miles under their belts.
The boys have done all of the qualifying races for the Rolex Fastnet race, so they are well aware of what the challenge is. I think they're a bit apprehensive about the amount of time that we're going to spend on the boat, but they've coped with all conditions before, and they've been on the boat for 3 days, 2 nights before, so I don't think the challenge is something they can't overcome.
Race day saw the pressure build, but at least Cowes was familiar. They trained and raced the Etchells here and started their first major event in Scaramouche, the Round the Island race, from here too. But this was the big one.
I'm excited to do the Fastnet.
Big project, big race, 600 miles. Looking forward to it.
The biggest ever Fastnet fleet was off. Project Scaramouche was underway.
Time's now 10 o'clock. We're getting up, going upstairs, getting ready to do our night shift. The first day was as I expected, but hopefully the days after this one aren't that bad. Getting ready to get some dinner now also.
Round the Needles, it was very tough, but this morning the wind dropped a bit.
It's going pretty well. It's been a little rough earlier yesterday, but we've all held through and no one's gotten sick so far.
It's now 6 o'clock in the morning. There's Land's End and now we're heading for the Fastnet Rock.
This leg was going to be a long one.
Just a moment ago we saw a few dolphins. Due to the conditions we couldn't make a big breakfast, so we just had some porridge, cereal bar, some fruit and some water.
So far, it's going quite well. When we get to the rock, the thing I'll be looking for is turning around, putting the spinnaker up, because I am the main bowman, so I'll get action into it.
And that time was getting closer.
So right now we're at the Fastnet Rock. Quite struggling to get around it because the wind keeps on dying and the tide keeps on pushing us up to it. So we've been doing a series of tacks to try and get past it, and it looks like we might get past it soon.
3 days after starting the race, they had rounded the famous lighthouse.
Night before we rounded the Fastnet Rock, it was gusting around 28 knots. So going up wind around about 12 o'clock at night, grueling, very cold. I say that's the bit where you are pushed the most throughout the Fastnet. That was the highest part of the race in terms of difficulty. And the best moment for me throughout the race was rounding the rock and basically helming and surfing the waves back to Plymouth, because I knew every wave that we surfed would take us much closer to Plymouth.
With the spinnaker up, running downwind required concentration. As the finish drew nearer, their dream was close to becoming a reality.
I'm looking forward to a hot meal and, you know, decent food and some rest. But overall, it's just been a great learning experience. And I hope to, you know, review what's happened during the race.
Then drama as the spinnaker blew out.
So the wind was picking up and we were sailing back along, and then the spinnaker was getting quite pressured highly, and it basically just popped open. So then we had to quickly grab in the spinnaker, bring it down the hatch, and just composedly bring out the Genoa and just continue sailing along. So we roughly have 20 miles to go, and I'm just going to get an hour's kip for the finishing line of the Fastnet 2017.
After more than 5 days at sea, they had exceeded their expectations, finishing 144th overall from 368 entries. An impressive performance.
38-27.
But this wasn't the end of their journey.
Now that I've done the Fastnet, I could now officially say that I'm a lot more resilient, because being able to cope on such a long journey, 5 days, is a big thing to do.
For all of us, we're all going to do actuals for the rest of the year, and some Skyrimish-related stuff, but mainly we're doing actuals because we're preparing to do different races going out in Miami, and this could lead on to doing other races such as the World Championships in 2018.
The Fastnet had been both a challenge and a catalyst. For the Greg City Academy, a longer voyage in sailing was now underway.